Good day, folks. My name is Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in beautiful Eugene, Oregon. We've been here for about 25 years, serving customers just like you that are looking to get into their first, second, 10th RV. I'm here today to show you this really, really nice 2003 Holiday Rambler Atlantis 29-foot with only 26,000 miles. With all units that have slide outs, you'll generally find they will be built on the 450 heavy duty Ford chassis. That's because the braking system needs to be a little bit heavier than the 350 chassis, and it's powered with the big Triton V10 motor. Very nice on the outside. You can see the high sheen as far as on the finish with the fiberglass. We have molded running boards down below, which is really nice. Back in this area here, it's powered with an Onan 4K. A gas generator runs everything pretty much inside the coach. And with the Holiday Rambler, folks, Curtis can just come up here right now. This is a free hung sidewall. And if you notice, we've got pop rivets. So it's a little bit different than a laminated wall. Basically, there's no way that this can delaminate because it's not glued and bonded. That's why Airstream has been in business for as long as what they have, and everybody brags about the Airstream construction. Holiday Rambler is built basically the same way. Nice awning covering the entrance door. And when we go inside, I'll show you that furnace below the refrigeration on here. Now this is what they refer to as a basement coach. So basement, it's gonna sit a little higher on the inside, but also with a basement coach, it allows me for full pass-through storage. Plus my holding tanks are gonna be up insulated inside of a cavity. So if we wanna use this for cold weather, as long as we've got my furnace on, we don't have any problems. Back in this area here, I'll try and lift this up, is where the spare tire is located. And if you notice, that is a full pass-through storage area down below. On the back end, we have traditionally a receiver hitch down below with a plug-in. I have a ladder to get up on my roof. Need be to service it, but also we go over to the 4th of July fireworks in Newport, and everybody gets up on top of their roof with their lounge chairs to watch the fireworks. Kind of nice getting up, a little scary getting down at nighttime though when it's dark. Got to watch out for that rogue brewery over there. Back on the back end here, we have where my 30 amp hookup is, right in here. And that's a 30 amp hookup that's got the automatic switch over, so I don't have to plug it back into a receptacle. Here's where my holding tanks are all up in a cavity area. They're all enclosed. Close this off right down in here. And over here on this side, I've got a light where I can turn on my light for at nighttime. And I've got some connections here for my fresh water. Right in here, I have my gas fill. That's a lockable compartment, which is very nice. Nothing really down here. I do have my chrome wheel liners down here. Tires are in very, very nice condition. And I do have my Carefree of Colorado awning that is coming out with my slide out. So I'm real excited to go inside and show you this real nice layout. It's pretty much designed for a couple. The way they've had it set up, the previous customers, very different. Originally, folks, up in this area over here, we had a small sleeper sofa, which they took out. And as you can see, they custom built some supports down here for these nice chairs. Up in the front, I do have my cab over sleeping area. This will pull down and make into the full bed. I have leather chairs, which is kind of nice little finish. And I do have heated remote control mirrors over on the left-hand side. Now most of them, this area in here could be a little bit, I'm going to step down, Curtis, sometimes can be a little bit awkward to get in and out of. Now my wife travels with me, and this actually is removable. So where if I disconnect this right here, I can sit this over here, and then it's a lot easier for her to get in and out. That was something I bet some of you folks didn't know on these Fords. Table and chairs are over here on my curbside, so I'd be looking out underneath my awning if I was camping. I do have the soft touch vinyl ceilings, which is really nice, especially for cleaning. Keeps the noise down too on the inside. as we swing around here, I have an 8 cubic foot refrigerator freezer up above, and my galley area is on my slide out, so I have my 3 burner stove, nice microwave convection oven, a little bit larger than standard microwave, and if you notice, I've got the real nice stainless sink with a larger area on one area and the wash side on the other. I don't think I have, no ice maker in this one, Curtis. So going back into the bedroom, and we'll do the bedroom first and then turn around and do the bathroom. My bed is slid out right now over here, and in doing so, it affords me a real nice wardrobe. And then I have up in here more storage down below with drawers, and I have a couple of really nice drawers that pull out. Over here, little counter space area with a 110 plug-in. I have my flat screen TV here, and I have my DVD player right over here. Now, not with the with the queen bed sliding out, there usually isn't that much storage underneath, but let's take a look. Well, they've really utilized this area with their slide on in the bed. Nice little storage cavity, as you can see, and Curtis is showing you. Now, Curtis has to turn around here to show you the bathroom, and I'll keep talking while he's doing that. So like I say, this is a really, really nice O3, very well cared for. If you're looking for a double slide classy motorhome, this might pique your interest. Over on the other side, we have a nice shower with a small tub, skylight up above. So you can be 6'5" and still fit in that. I do have an emergency window in the back, right in here, which sometimes if you want to, you can leave it open for a little bit of ventilation, put a little stick in here. Of course, you wouldn't want to do that at nighttime for safety precautions. We have quite a few Class Cs that will come through here. Some are shorter, some are longer, never knowing what your needs are. I'd love to work with you. I've been doing this since 1976, selling recreational vehicles here in Lane County. So please, my name's Raymond Moore with the RV Corral. Thank you for watching this movie. And if I can help you, or even if you just want to stop in on the lot and say, yeah, I saw Ray in the video with this Atlantis, please just ask for me. Have a great day, folks, and thanks for watching the video.